So let's go ahead and write a note now. You'll likely be doing a shift assessment during your clinical rotation. I'm not going to go through in detail what is covered in an actual nursing shift assessment note, but I will show you how to find and start one. Let's look down at the bottom of the document list pane, and we can see a box that says New Note. Click on this to bring up the search function to choose a note title. Now, when you click on this, you're not going to see a nice list of saved notes that I have here. So we're going to have to type in the note that we're looking for in this progress note title box. Progress notes are listed in alphabetical order by note title, but usually have the prefix INPAT for inpatient or NSG for nursing. Common titles you may see in your first year are a nursing progress note or a nursing shift assessment. If you don't remember the full title, we can just type in shift, and the first one that comes up here is the nursing shift assessment. I'm going to double click on this note here in a minute to bring up the actual note, but I wanted to show you a couple other things on this box. The date and time of the note is the date and time that you're currently writing your note right now, not when you actually performed the assessment. And then just below that box, we're going to see the author. This will be your name here, but underneath your name, you will also need to select your cosigner. Your nurse preceptor is likely the cosigner, and she or he is going to verify your note to make sure it's correctly written. If you expect to have the same preceptor during your clinical rotation, you can select him or her as the default cosigner by selecting Tools, Options, Notes, Configure defaults for editing and saving notes, and then here we can actually put in a default cosigner, and we'll look he or she up by their last name. So I'm going to open up that nursing shift assessment note again. Oops. Double click on your note that you've chosen to bring up the actual note. It may take a minute or so. So as you can see here, this is our inpatient nursing shift assessment note. Most of the notes you'll see or write on CPRS have a default template with radio boxes that we can click, which prompts selection of information which will populate into the note. Some notes will appear as a blank page where you will have to free text what you want your note to say. So the nursing shift assessment, for example, we'll have to go through and click on each radio button to make sure we're hitting each one of our systems, because that's what we did when we did our physical assessment. Now, any radio button that's circled or starred requires an answer or a text option. So for example, does our patient have glasses? Yes or no, we'll need to click on that. And the confusion assessment method, it's circular, so we'll need to click on that. So each system in the nursing shift assessment will have a comments box where you can free type your physical assessment, the findings that you found when you did it, or you can hit this accept for button and chart that way. So each accept for will have a list of kind of common findings or uncommon findings that we can click on and make sure we highlight that. If you don't find something in the accept for section, you can always go up to the comments and free type what you'd like to say there. Be sure to click and address every system here on the nursing shift assessment note. Now, when you're totally done writing your note, you can hit finish. And what CPRS will do is it'll go through your note and make sure that you've clicked on all of the circular radio buttons or the starred items that we have to enter into our system. Whatever you've forgotten will show up here. So we'll need to go back and find those. Now I'm not going to go through and actually find those because it'll take a little bit. I'm just going to cancel out of it. But when we were finished with our note and everything was filled in correctly, our note would now appear on the right side of the screen once we've hit that finish button. When you're ready to sign, you can right-click on your note and save it without signature if you think you might go back and edit some stuff later. I would actually recommend this because you and your preceptor can both go over your note and edit as you'd like. If we choose sign note now, that means if we wanted to go back to our note and add some sections or edit anything, we would have to write a separate note as an addendum. But it's okay if you think your note's good and you're ready to sign note now. Additionally, you can include an additional signer if you want to notify him or her of any of the information you've put in your notes. So again, we can right-click on the body of our note and choose Identify Additional Signer. It won't do it on my note because I didn't actually write it, but another box will come in prompting you to choose the signer that you'd want, and you can choose that person by last name first. Now in the second part of the series, I'm going to go into much greater detail on how to actually write a note and create a list of your favorite note titles, which will make it easy for you to readily access any notes instead of using the search box every time.